Thank you for watching us on YouTube. Global Diplomat College Center vision is transforming students into leaders, leaders and agents of change. I want to focus on what I persuaded and I believe in Kingdom of God living on the earth in the year 2020. Our session is Power, Discipline, and Vision of Leadership, Part 2. Power, Discipline, and Vision of Leadership, Part 2. I will give you this concept of the message. One, true vision is the source of discipline. Two, all leaders must have the quality of self-discipline. You are not a leader if you don't have self-discipline. Discipline is the source of leadership. Vision is the key to having discipline. To see it become reality, the larger your vision, the greater your discipline. Discipline comes from the root word, disciple. Means students, learner, disciple, students, learner. 12 disciples were learners of the Lord Jesus Christ, his message. Discipline began within you. It's not without, it's within. Am I making myself clear? It is within. It's called self discipline, with rules and guidance, your morals, self-discipline is voluntary. Self-discipline is voluntary. Successful leadership possess quality of self-discipline. I'll say it again. Successful leadership possess the quality of self-discipline. The Bible is called the law of God. The Bible is the constitution of the kingdom of heaven. Heaven is an invisible country. It's called the kingdom of heaven. God is the king of heaven. He spoke to in the book of Habakkuk, subsection 2:2, New King James Version of the Bible. Then the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. He said, write the vision and make it plain on tablet, that he may run. That read it. It's time to run with your vision. That read it. I'm making myself clear. What is your vision? Have you a clearly written down your vision? Have you clearly written down your vision? Help you to define your vision began by what you are thinking. Your vision began of what you are thinking. It's saying why? There are 15 principles of your vision. 15. How much? 15 principles. How many, Pastor Alvin?
15 principles
of your vision. 1. Why are you here on earth? You should ask yourself that question. Why are you here on earth? What is your purpose? The word purpose means intent, will. The word purpose means counsel. What is your purpose here on earth? That's 2. 3. Why are you doing? And what you're doing? Why you do it? And what you do? That's 3. 4. What do you value? What do you value? What motivates you? 6. What makes you laugh? What makes you cry? What makes tears come from your eyes? 8. What will get you out of the bed in the morning? What gets you out of the bed in the morning? What wakes you up? What gets you out of the bed in the morning? 10? What are you willing to die for? What are you willing to die for? What are you willing to live for? Where are you going when you leave this earth? Where are you going when you leave this earth? 13. What message must you share with the world? What is your message you have for humanity, mankind? 14. What legacy will you leave to the world? Why? 15. Why? Let's say why. Why, Pastor?
Why?
Why mean purpose? Why 98% of people die without fulfilling their vision? What is the purpose for 98% of people die? Go in the graveyard, go in the cemetery, without fulfilling their God-given purpose. Albert Einstein, quote, he was the fittest. He was one of the great leaders of physics. He quote this, never give up. What really worth to do, what you really want to do, the person that have the big dream is more powerful than the one with all the facts. I'll read it again. Albert Einstein's quote, never give up. What really wants you to do, the person with the biggest dream is more powerful than the one with all the facts. True vision all within. True vision all within. In the Constitution, the manufacturer that made humanity, God Elohim, Abba Father, or source, or sustainer, or provider, give this letter. Ephesians is the letter, call it epistle, to Paul, who is an apostle by the will of God. The statement reads, out of the Constitution, I pray the eyes of your heart. I pray, let's quote it, Pastor Elby, I pray the eyes of your heart,
may be enlightened,
in order that you may know the hope to which he called you, the riches of his glorious inheritance of his holy people, kingdom citizen. I pray that you will know the vision which is in your heart. You may be enlightened to the vision that God has given you, and that you may have the knowledge, and you may have the faith and hope, which is to the call, that vision God sent you to earth to do. I want to explain to you, everything God created, he have a vision for it. the birds, the cattle, the ants, the elephant, the lion, the tiger, the cat, all the animals, every human being. There are 7.8 billion humans on the earth. All the trees, all the mountains, all the river, everything, you have a vision for it. God is committed to his vision for what he had made. In other words, every manufacturer that make a product have a vision for it. Every car that is made, the manufacturer that make the car have a vision for it. Every TV, every computer, every bus, every building are made by vision. Everything that you can see came out of vision. I pray that your eyes, not your eyesight. When you don't have a vision, you live by what you see. But when you have a vision, you live by what you believe. Your work and your gift. Your work is different from your gift. Your work is what others pay you to do. Your gift is what God had placed within your heart. It is within. Leaders are leaders from within. You can train a person to be a leader. You can make them a leader. They are a leader. Born leaders are within. I pray that the eyes of your heart, I see from my heart, be enlightened in order that you may know the knowledge, the hope, the faith to which he have called you, that the riches of his glorious inheritance of his holy people, kingdom citizen. Now, Proverbs 4. This is interesting. Wow. Proverbs 4, 23. Above all, guard your heart, for everything you do flow from it. Wow, Pastor, wow, that's powerful. God, protect, watch what's going in your heart. Watch what you listen to on the TV, on the radio. Watch what people are saying to you. Watch what you're listening to. Because everything you listen to, go in your heart. Guard it, protect it. Out of it flow everything. All your vision is stored in your heart. For example, the eagle that flies, his vision is stored in his eyes. He can see 5 miles ahead of him and capture the prey. His vision is in his eyes. Your vision is in your heart. True leaders are self-imposed. Let's say it, Pastor. True leaders
are self-imposed.
Self-imposed defined as something that you require or expect of yourself rather than someone else reveal it to you. What you have inside of you, you discipline yourself. You discipline your spirit. You control your vehicle when you go on the street. If you ride a motorbike, you control it. If you ride tricycle, every driver control what he rides. Well, you got to control you, your heart, because your vision is in the inside. Matthew 5:5. Blessed are the what? Meek. For they shall inherit real estate. Wow. That's interesting. Blessed are what? Meek. The word meek means to be humble. Humility. The word meek means control. Self-discipline. For they shall what? Inherit real estate. The only thing on earth is real. It's called real estate. Your car depreciated. Your house depreciated. Your clothes depreciated. Your dress depreciated. Every appliance in your house depreciated. But the only thing lasts is real estate. When you meet, you shall inherit real estate. Proverbs 25:28. A man without self-discipline, man who do not have, women who do not have, wives who do not have self-discipline, is like a city broken in and left without walls. You know, when a city is destroyed and all the buildings break down, it is chaos. It's disaster. When you don't have self-control, when you don't have discipline, when you get angry, when you get mad, when you argue, when you want to show a different part of you, you are like a broken down city with no walls. Am I making myself clear? The most important thing in life that brings you success and achievement is self-discipline. Out of self-discipline is from vision. True vision is the source of self-discipline and come from vision. Sit down. If you have a business and you husbands, I'm speaking to you, you fathers, sit down to your table at home or in your office in a quiet place and write a mission statement for your family. Your wife should ask you before she married you, where are you going? What is your vision? Not I love you, baby. You're so wonderful, honey. And all those sweet talk, you talk to her and she talk to you. The main conversation should be, what is your mission, your vision statement, and what is your mission for our life? Mission, vision is like a road map that give you direction to a city to find a place. What is your vision? Vision statement helps you to understand the meaning or purpose for your business. Vision statement give you goals for your life future. Every company and corporation, if you notice when you go in these company and you see on their wall in the office or in a lobby or any place, they have their mission statement. Write down what is the company. It's good for the employer to have a mission statement for the employee to know where the company is going. Would you ride a bus or a tricycle or car and you don't know your destination? Vision give you a clear destination. Come from the word destiny. Give you destination. What is your destination? What is your mission? What is your vision? Am I making myself clear to you?
Amen.
Now, there was a baby. His name was Moses. And his mother could not support him. And she placed him in the river. And his mama had a sister to watch over him. And there came Pharaoh's daughter to draw water from the Nile. And she saw this basket with this baby in the basket. Your vision could be in the basket, floating in the river. And she gets that baby and he cries. He cried. And she said, this is my baby. I'm taking him in the palace. And she take Moses in the palace and he learned the way of the Egyptian. But what she was taking in the palace is the author, one who writes 5 books, who writes the 10 commandments, who's the greatest leader the earth I've ever seen. Now, this is Moses, Pio. Am I making myself clear? In our Numbers 12:3. Am I making myself clear? Numbers 12:3. It reads, and the Lord heard it. Now, Moses was very humble. Moses then, of all the men who were on the earth, Moses was the humblest man in the whole world. He was the disciplinedest man in the world. It's God can say that about you. Are you the disciplined woman in the world? Are you the disciplined leader in the world? True leaders demand discipline. What true leaders demand? Discipline. Now, I will reveal this revelation. In the book of Revelation, open up. Everything God created, he created with a vision. Revelation. I will read in the book of Revelation 1, the revelation of Jesus Christ. Amen, Pastor.
Amen.
The revelation of Jesus Christ. In other words, it's saying the word revelation means self-discipline, vision. The word revelation means vision. The vision of who? Jesus Christ, which God gave to him to show his servant the things which must surely take place. You see the vision before it happened. If you're going to build a house, you see the blueprint before the house is built. God show him the blueprint of the vision before. Show to his servant the things which must surely take place. And he sent and sanctified it by his angel to his servant John, who bear the witness of the word of God and the testimony of Jesus Christ. testimony of Jesus Christ, the things that he saw. That he what?
That he saw.
He saw that he had a vision of. So John, one of the apostles, had a vision, saw. He said he was in the spirit, and he saw. Blessed is he who reads. You gotta read, a vision is read. You gotta write your vision. This God vision that he gave to John on the Isle of Patmos. Blessed is he who reads, these who hear the word of the prophecy and keep the things which are written in it, for the time is near. John to the seven churches which is in Asia. God showed a vision of the seven churches. This session will continue going on the visions of the churches. Grace to you, peace from him who is, who was, to come, from the seven spirit, which is before the throne. He showed him the vision of heaven and from Jesus Christ, the faithful witness, and the first begone from the dead, and to the rulers of the kings of the earth, to him who loves us, washes from our sin, and made us kings and priests unto God. To him be glory and dominion forever and ever. Amen. Behold, he cometh with a cloud, and every eye shall see him. Even those fear him, and all the tribes of the earth shall mourn because of him. Even so, amen. I'm Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, said the Lord, who is and was, is to come, the Almighty. Now, I, John, both your brother and your companion of tribulation and kingdom and patience, Jesus Christ, on the Isle of Patmos, for the word of God and the testimony of Christ, I was in the spirit on the Lord's day, and I heard a voice, a trumpet saying, I'm Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last, which is right. See the vision and write. When you see your vision, you write. Write your vision. Write your vision. Am I making myself clear? Every human that come to planet Earth, God has given you a vision. God wants you to fulfill God's given plan for your life. But God has purpose in your heart. This is Joseph, God's holy prophet and ambassador. This time, I'll ask God, pastor, ambassador of Global Diplomat College Center, Manila, Philippines, Antipolo City, to pray. Pastor?
Hallelujah. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the word today. We thank you for the vision that you placed inside our hearts. May we pray, eyes of our understanding be enlightened, the knowledge of the power of our Lord and the riches of the glory of your inheritance in us. May you raise up leaders, fulfilling the God-given vision that you place inside of us. We will be done. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glory of the covered by heaven and earth. Amen. And amen.
Go get your vision. Run! 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 God give you a business, run with it! God give you a vision, run with it, run! Run, run! Run, run, run! Run on! With your vision, run, run! Do not die without your vision being fulfilled! Run, run, run on! Of the earth.